Welcome to TMS WEB Core version 2.0. The following video will introduce you to some of the many new controls in this gigantic 2.0 release. First, there is a flexible drop-down control. You might have seen similar controls in the VCL. This control will allow you to make any visual control a drop-down. Then you can use it like a combo box or an edit box with a combo box. The dropdown will also be fully interactive. So let's say you use a grid, you can make selections inside of that grid and react using standard events of that control, what is selected, or even support editing. Selecting countries is a common thing we encounter as end users in web applications. TMS Web Core now makes it very easy with combo boxes and list boxes to select countries. As a visual aid, flags can be added to the names of the countries. Finally, one of my personal favorites, the list boxes will now be available with checkboxes. One of the biggest improvements with regards to visual controls are the additions to grids and Triviews. Grids can now embed any control. As you can see here on the right, you can embed checkboxes, progress bars, buttons. Furthermore, built-in sorting is as simple as flipping a property for each column, and the grid can be sorted with user interaction. The embedded controls are not only being shown, full user interaction is possible, meaning you can change the state of the checkboxes in the screenshot shown on the right. You can also click on each individual button shown in the grid, and you can also determine which row the button is associated with. In this demonstration, you'll meet two new controls, the web dropdown control and the checklist box control. Selecting the dropdown shows the checklist box. Here I can click on the checkboxes and change their state, which also changes the text in the web dropdown control. This is all possible with a few clicks. Drop two controls on the form, the web check list box and the web dropdown control. Then add the data to the items property of your list box. You've been doing this since Delphi 1. In order to link the checklist box to the dropdown control, simply set the control property to the name of the checklist box. You can also select it from a list. That's it. Now the dropdown control will show the checklist box. In order to add interaction for updating the text of the dropdown control, you can add events to the checklist box. For example, on-click check. Also, if you set the value in the dropdown control, you can update the checklist box using the on-dropdown event. As said during the presentation of the slides, you can drop down any visual control. Here you see a string grid that is being dropped down as a control. And of course, full interaction for the rows being hovered over and selection of a row is supported. In this case, we return the value of the second column with the column index number 1. So in the source code, if you look at the onClick event of the table control, we return the value of the cell with the column index 1. Offering selection of a country has never been easier. First, there is the TWEB country combo box, then the TWEB country list box, and the TWEB country dropdown. All these feature the name of the country, and in addition to the name of the country, also a flag. The flags are being loaded, as you could just see, on demand, meaning your web application stays responsive while the flags are being loaded. You can decide if you want to show the flags in your dropdown, or if you just want to show the names of the countries. In order to determine which country has been selected, you can use the usual text properties or, with regards to the list box, the item index property. Let's finish this video with a look at the improvements of grids and Triviews. With a single line of code, you can embed a checkbox, a progress bar, or a button to any cell. You simply specify the coordinate of the cell you want to embed either the checkbox, the progress bar, or the button. Also, in order to support sorting, you simply specify the header row and add a sort indicator and specify if the default sorting should be ascending or descending. In this case, both columns sort in ascending order. After preparing your grid in the way you see here, you can also add values like you used to using the coordinate system of the grid. Button clicks trigger the onButtonClick event. You can there decide, using the column and the row, which button was pressed. Looking at the end result created with these few lines of code, it's pretty impressive. You can select different rows using the checkbox. You can change the sort by cars, sort by price. The rating is visually displayed using a progress bar, and each button can be clicked to purchase a certain vehicle. I always fancied myself an Audi GT RS, so I click buy. After clicking the button, the event is triggered and the correct line is being referred to. Well, looking at the price, maybe not today. For an in-depth look at all these components, Bruno Fierens did a webinar, which is available on our YouTube channel. He'll introduce more details how to use these great new controls. And everything else about TMS Web Core, you'll find at web.tmssoftware.com.